Next question is from David Acao Training. What tips do you have for introverted personal trainers?
You know what's funny about this is there's a myth that being introverted means you're not going to be successful as a coach or a trainer. I believe this when I first started as well, because I wouldn't consider myself an extrovert. Depends on the environment. I could be both. But if I'm in a gym, I'm an extrovert. That's my place. I'm comfortable. I'll talk to anybody. It's not a big deal. So I thought that that was necessary for success as a personal trainer. And then through the years, I've had enough trainers who were extremely successful with their clients, extremely successful with their revenue, with how much they produced, that were not, that I would consider to be introverted. And they did very well. And then I said to myself, okay, you don't have to be an extrovert to be a successful coach.
Well, especially today with content creation, like the ability to, to post or write, like if you can write well, or have a creative side to you, as far as content creation on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram and blogging and writing white papers, like there's a lot of potential for you to have some success in that, especially if you can put some words together pretty well.
Yeah, Justin, you're of the three of us, you're the most, I would say, introverted in that sense. Adam and I are more similar.
Yeah.
But you were also very, very successful. Did you have any specific strategies?
I kind of weave back and forth. But yeah, when I'm in business mode, like I'm very much introverted. Like I want to make sure everything I have to present is perfect, and I'm very analytical of what I want to portray myself as. And so I had a hard time just like throwing myself out there and talking to random people I've never talked to before. So it took a lot of work for me to get through that, because at the end of the day, this is a very interpersonal job. Is you have to like people, to like talking to people. So if that's something that's like way outside yourself, maybe it's not a good fit. But like maybe something like, if you're really into fitness, like writing or providing some kind of content where you can do that from your house makes sense. But if you want to work through that, there's ways to do that. So, and you guys have actually experienced some of that when we did we started our improv training, stuff like that, where it just kind of, it forces you to not live so much in your head. You have to come out with it. You have to immerse yourself and sort of release the fact that maybe I'm not going to say the right thing every single time, or maybe, I got to take it in small steps. So for me, it was more about taking it in small steps of, first thing is to just hang out where the conversations are easier to come across. So if I'm in the front desk and somebody's coming in, I learn their name, I just say hi. Like I just take it in small strides. I just say hi. They come back, I remember their name. I say, we'll see you next time, Joe, whoever, right? And then you start to kind of like build rapport. I always think that you put too much pressure as an introvert on trying to get all these things nailed down like right away. It's just about, putting yourself out there, getting to know people, like how long have you been here? Very simple conversations. You don't need to go for the clothes right away. You need to get outside yourself first and get to know people. And then, it just starts to line up towards deeper conversations that lead you towards, maybe even turn them into a client.
I also don't think you should stress this too much either. I think you should double and triple down on your strengths. Maybe spend 20% of your time doing these classes that are going to work on your speech, or 20% of the time putting yourself in these uncomfortable situations to try and get you better at that. But I think if you're naturally an introverted person, stressing about, oh my God, I'm introverted and I need to be extroverted if I'm going to be this good trainer,
a waste of time.
Is not only a waste of time, but it's going to become stressful as fuck, because it's not who you are.
Yeah.
Accept who you are and double and triple down on your strengths. And a good example, talking about Justin and comparing to the two of us, there was a time when you went off on your own doing your own thing. I was running my own thing. Justin had a website 10 times better than mine, and you built all that. You had the ability to sit down and write and create all that content, and you're much better at that than I am. Maybe I'm better at walking up to random strangers on the street and hustling them into my classes.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, you probably drove more leads to your business with your strength on your website than I was able to on my website. So if you're an introverted person, instead of focusing on that you're not good at that, focus on what you're good at and be great at it. You know, find those areas that do make you a good trainer. You know, and double and triple down on that, and then spend a little bit of time trying to develop the skills that maybe that like we're talking about.
Yeah, and yeah, I think 100%. Also there's a misunderstanding that training people is an extroverted process or activity. It's not. When you're training a client one-on-one, it's you and your client. And many introverts flourish in that environment. They're really good at developing deep connections, making their clients feel very comfortable and at home and secure with them, which is a very important thing to do as a trainer. The only part I could see, well, here's where I think the challenge can come from is, oh, what about getting clients? That's where the fear.
That is the big challenge.
That's the fear. But there's many ways to create opportunities to where the, like you said, Justin, working the front desk, like the conversation comes to you, or setting up a booth, a free body fat test, right? That sets up the conversation.
Well, again, I go back to what I say. Like, I mean, yes, it is the stressful part for this person is the lead generation. Well, lead generate other ways. Write a blog.
Totally.
You know, create a great website that draws people in.
Technology is beautiful.
Yes, this.
I love that you brought that up because I did. That's all I thought about was like, how can I hack this? You know, to be more beneficial towards me. And you know, yeah, I looked at a lot of the. Sort of presentation binders at the front of the gym. And I'm like, and I made sure because I could sit there on my computer and do all these things and like write, like copy and like, you know, really build myself up in terms of writing, you know, I got a lot of business that way too. And so you just kind of look for other opportunities where people will come across it, maybe pick up the phone and call you and just, you know, figure out ways. Now online, obviously social media and all these other things play a factor.
Absolutely.
Hey, if you enjoyed that clip, you can find the full episode here, or you can find other clips over here. And be sure to subscribe.